السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، وصلى الله وسلم على رسوله الكريم وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. اما بعد، فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ان المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات، اعد الله لهم مغفره واجرا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. I begin in the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Send my humble salutations upon Prophet Muhammad, his companion, his family members, and those who follow the footsteps in the day of resurrection. Alhamdulillah, it's a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are able to come to the house of Allah Azza wa Jal in these days and nights of this blessed month of Ramadan. This is a very unique blessing of the Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal, and as much as we thank Allah for it, it's always less. So every single day when you finish your fast, when you are able to finish your Taraweeh prayer and you're going home, acknowledge and say to Allah Azza wa Jal that, oh Allah, I am thankful that you have given me the ability to do this. Right? La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There is no might, there is no ability for a person to obey Allah, nor his ability to stay away from the sin except from the blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal. So let's try to acknowledge it on a daily basis in our life. We talked about two things in the past two Khateras about the characteristics of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is being mentioned in Surah Al-Ahzab, Surah number 33 in the Quran. So today we are going to touch on the third aspect of it. Now, does anybody remember those two things? Qawl al-Sadeena was last night. Okay. Did I hear a toothbrush somewhere? No? Okay. Qawl al-Sadeena was last night. Straight talk. Be accurate, clear, to the point in your talk. And the first line we talked about, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. Yes, obeying Allah and obeying His Prophet, putting Allah and His Prophet the first one to follow in your life. The third, which I'm going to talk about, is today, which is entitled or connected with the ayah number 35 in Surah Al-Ahzab. And this characteristic is a very important one. And every character of the Prophet ﷺ is an important one in our life. And we should try our best to implement that into our life. But today's one is very unique. And the reason, does anybody know why we have been giving different characteristics of the Prophet ﷺ for Surah Al-Ahzab? Right? There has to be a connection with that, right? Different things have been mentioned about the Prophet ﷺ, his characters. Multiple characters have been mentioned in this surah. Because this surah holds an ayah which describes the Prophet ﷺ as the greatest example for humanity. Right? In Surah Al-Ahzab, ayah number 21, what does Allah say? لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنٌ. Correct. Ayah number 21, Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah mentions, in the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, there is the best of example Allah has kept for you. Now let's see what's this best of example in today's talk we can implement into our life. This ayah number 35 in Surah Al-Ahzab was revealed on an incident. And that will be the character that we need to develop in our life, and that is empowering women. Right? Does that sound Islamic?
Yes.
Does that sound Islamic? Because for many people that doesn't sound Islamic. Empowering women. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Apart from many things, one of the things that he did in his life and he made an example of himself is giving the rights to the woman, understanding their temperament and honoring their emotions, right? Understanding their temperament and honoring their emotions. So this ayah 35 was revealed in one of the ways that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam empower the woman, honoring them in their sentiments, in their emotions, and giving the understanding to the believers that how you are dealing with this, right? So this is why in this surah, Allah Azza wa Jal has told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by addressing him in two different ways how to deal with this. The first category of the woman is the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his household. So Allah says, "Ya ayyuhan nabi, qul li azwajik." Right? This is also mentioned in this surah. O Prophet, tell your wives. And then, "Ya ayyuhan nabi, qul li azwajik wa banatik wa nisa'il mu'minin." Right? This is also mentioned in this surah. That, O Prophet, alayhi salatu wa salam, tell your wives, your daughters, and the general Muslim woman, nisa'il mu'minin. So in this surah, Allah Azza wa Jalla covers both of the aspects in regards to how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam empowered and he respected and honored the woman, Muslim woman in the community. So this ayah, ayah number 35, إِنَّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ إِلَىٰ آخِرِهِ, was revealed when few of the Sahabiyat, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the woman companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well as one of the Ummahat al-Mu'mineen, Umm Salama radiallahu anha, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said, O Prophet of Allah, when we look into the Quran, we hear and we listen and we read that Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned many things about the men, right? Allah has mentioned many things about the men. So what about the woman? Any ayah has been revealed for that purpose? I'm going to take your undivided attention, because if you were to look into ayah number 22 in the same surah, what does Allah say? من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه. Ayah number 22. Now we're going to compare ayah number 22 with ayah number 35. In ayah number 22, Allah is honoring the men of the Muslim community. In ayah number 35, Allah is honoring the women of the Muslim community. In one surah, Allah put both of it together. So tomorrow, no one has an objection. This is the beauty of Quran. This is the beauty of Quran. So in ayah number 22, Allah says, مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الرِّجَالُ, amongst the believers, there are men. صَدَقُوا مَا عَهَدُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ, they fulfill what they promised they had made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In ayah number 35, Allah is answering to the call of the Sahabiyat, the woman companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. On their request, Allah revealed this verse, إِنَّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَالْقَانِتِينَ وَالْقَانِتَاتِ, the Muslim woman and the man, the Muslim, the believing woman and man, the devoting woman and man, and then the ayah carries on. So in this surah, apart from many other characters that have been mentioned about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very particular in regards to when it came to the matter of honoring the Muslim women in the community. Now, why this surah is connected with that? There was something that I mentioned in my first Khatera that has connection with this, so that's why you need to listen attentively, you know? Put your undivided attention. We are here to learn, inshallah. In these 15 minutes, they are very, you know, it requires, because you have to bring down to a very minimal aspect to give to the point. And at that time, 15 minutes, I think, is a good portion for people to give their attention to. One thing I mentioned about Surah Al-Ahzab was, this was the surah which was revealed in regards to the battle of Trench, Khandaq, right? In the battle of Trench, there were two sides Muslims were being attacked. Number one was outside, which were the people of Mecca, on the other side of the trench, right? And the second was
inside,
Banu Qurayza, right? Well, the Sahaba were taking care how to deal with the outside enemies. The Muslim women of that time were taking care of how to take care of the inside enemy, Banu Qurayza. And these were the sisters, the Sahabiyat, Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'een, who took part in a very great way in assisting the Muslims and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To the fact, helping those who were wounded, giving medicine to them, providing them with necessities of life, making food for them. In fact, some of the Mufassirin had mentioned that some of the women of that time worked even more harder than the brothers did, than the Sahaba did. And this is why Allah has especially honored them in this Sahabiyat. They came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with this concern. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam immediately honored their concern, and Allah honored their concern and revealed the verse. Allah honored their concern and revealed the verse immediately. And not only that, but throughout his life. So in this surah, Allah speaks about two aspects: the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the general Muslim woman. As far as the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was concerned, Urwa, we had mentioned Urwa in the first Khatera, Urwa ibn Zubair, right? He was one of the closest students of Aisha radiallahu anha, correct? So Urwa came to Aisha radiallahu anha and he asked Aisha, كيف كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في بيته وأهل بيته? How the Prophet was in his house? How was the Prophet alayhi salam in his house? You know, one third of the religion is received by the woman. In fact, Ibn Ashur mentions half of the religion has been received by the woman. 2,210 ahadith have been mentioned by Aisha radiallahu anha. If she was not part of the great fuqaha of Medina and brought that knowledge to us, and if you take out a woman factor from the equation and the mentality that people have in today's life, that Islam does not give any importance to this gender, in fact, we will be missing half of the religion from our life. Let's acknowledge that. We will be missing half of the religion from our life. So Aisha radiallahu anha was asked by Urwa radiallahu anhu, how was the Prophet alayhi salam in his house? Because his house is only known to his wife, nothing else, no one else, right? So Aisha radiallahu anha replied, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في مثنة أهل بيتي. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to assist his wives in the house. يعجن عجينا. He used to knead the dough. He used to sew his own clothes. He used to fix his own shoes. He used to go and fetch his own water. This is the Prophet عليه السلام والسلام. And what did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? All type of entertainment are considered to be lawful, not valid in the eyes of Allah azza wa jal, except for few entertainments. And amongst the few entertainments that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, one of them is أَن يَلْعَبَ بِأَهْلِ بَيْتِهِ. When a person entertains with his wife, right? And I'm not going to go into the details of entertainment of wives and family members, because after that, this Khatera will become rated R. So we don't want to do that. We want to keep it as, you know, as G as possible. So he used to entertain with his, he used to play with his wife. Playing meaning physical activities, sports, racing, going through different aspects of life. This is what the Prophet ﷺ would do. How he considered it to be part of his life. When it comes to the outside, now we talked about a little bit in his household. Let's go outside the household. How was his connection with the women of Medina? When Sahaba, when Sahabiyat used to come and ask him the question, Asma bint Yazid al-Khatiba li Ahli Medina. Asma bint Yazid radiallahu anha, she was appointed the leader of the women of Medina to go and ask the question to the Prophet. And what was her question? Her question was that, O Prophet of Allah, whenever we come to you, we always find the men around you. So is there any way that you can dedicate some time for us? Right? The Prophet said, no, everyone has to be equal. So you sit and I'll sit and everyone is going to sit and that's how we're going to deal with it. No, he did not say that. The Prophet said, okay, why don't you go back to the sisters and ask them which day they want for me to come and speak to them only. Rasulullah sallallahu, this is the riwayat of Sahih al-Bukhari. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam designated one day of the week just to give time to the sisters and the sahabiyat of Medina, listening to them. فَوَعِظُهُنَّ وَمُرْهُنَّ He would tell them, he would talk to them, he would resolve their issues, whatever concerns they will have, they will come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they will do that. Along with all the other chores and the needs that he had of the day, he would designate that. And any concern that came from them, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam considered it, and he made part of it, and he acknowledged it. He never let them go out. He never put them down. He always respected them. So empowering them, giving them that ability, giving them, and we need to understand them that on what level Islam actually went in taking care of that. Just to understand the pre-Islamic life, how the women were treated in that scenario, in that situation. So in today's talk, what are we going to take from our life, that we're going to take from the life of the Prophet and we are going to implement into our lives? Be a true man. Follow the characters of the Prophet. A real person, a real good individual in the sight of Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that person who is the best with his family members. خَيْوُكُمْ خَيْوُكُمْ لِأَهْلِي وَأَنَا خَيْوُكُمْ لِأَهْلِي The best amongst you is the one who is the best from his to his family members, and I am the best to my family members. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding to do that, give us the quality and the characteristics of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our life. And inshallah, if you do get time, study Surah Al-Ahzab. It's one of the very beautiful surahs of the Quran. And it has a lot of information. We cannot go through every aspect of it, but study Surah Al-Ahzab. Allah has mentioned great things in this surah. May Allah grant us the ability to do that, to practice upon what has been said. SubhanAllah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.